You think I'm
very boy.
Exactly. Exactly. So what does he need to?
I'm not
telling you slow, bro. I'm telling you that if you a simple brother or a simple sister, God's laws is gonna make you wise. Read it again, Casey ain't here.
The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple.
Bible said the testimony of the Lord is gonna make a simple brother wise. Alright? So if the shoe fits, you wear. Right? Right? The dog that barked, that's the one that got hit. Ain't that how the saying go? Right? So if you're not a simple brother, don't come to me telling me, hey, look, I'm not simple. Why you think I'm simple? All right? All right? All right, so the laws of God is going to take a brother, all right, that's out here selling drugs to his people. That's simple. Why? Why is that simple? Because what's that going to bring to your house? What's that going to bring to your home? What type of danger is that going to put your family in? All right? Where you more likely going to end up? In jail or in the kingdom of God? You're going to end up in jail. That's a simple thing. The laws of God will teach you to repent from being simple to becoming wise. Read that again.
The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple.
The Bible says it's a sure thing. This testimony is going to take you from being a simple brother to being a wise brother. All right?
If I was selling all right. drugs, this wallet would be full of cash.
All right, watch this. Get Proverbs chapter 1. Thank you. Verse 7. Read.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge.
Right, so the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. You got to have some fear for the Lord, all right, to take heed to his commandments. It got to be something in you saying, I don't want to continue doing the wrong thing. Let me make sure what I'm doing is right. Right? It got to be some fear in you that you want to get right with the Lord. God's chosen people, the blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, we roll with that. Right? It's something in us from the beginning that tells us that we got to do right by the Most High God. Right? We got to. It's something in us that says that. Right? Come on.
But fools despise wisdom and instruction.
The Bible says you got fools that's going to despise wisdom.
Yeah.
Fools that's going to hate instruction. Right, so if we're telling you to stop selling drugs, all right, and that make you upset, you're probably a fool. You're probably a simple brother, and you need God's laws to make you wise. All right, if you're a sister and you're walking out here with no clothes on, you're not covering yourself up, right? What you gonna attract? A whoremonger, all right? Are you gonna attract someone that's gonna wanna marry you and take care of you forever? No, you're gonna attract somebody that's gonna wanna have a one-night stand with you, all right? That's simple according to the Bible. We're teaching you, all right? A fool is going to reject that, right? But if you're wise, all right, if you have a good understanding, if you love the knowledge of God, you're going to repent from that. You're going to cover yourself up, all right? And you're going to keep God's commandments. Come on.
But fools despise wisdom and instruction. My son, hear the instruction of thy father.
The Bible says, hear the instruction of your father. What do? We hard-headed. We don't want to listen to nothing our father got to say. Most of us ain't even grow up with a father. So we didn't have any instruction from him at all to begin with. Right? But guess what? It's still hope for you, brother. Because this Bible is here to be your father. This Bible is here to be your, to provide you with the instruction that your father never gave you. Ooh. If you listen to these commandments, it will convert you from being a simple brother. All right, to being a brother that's wise, that understands how to make provisions for his family. The laws of God will do that. Come on.
My son, hear the instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother.
The Bible says, don't forsake the law of your mother, right? Because a father and a mother on one accord, right? A father should be in the household instructing the mother on how to instruct the children.
Right.
How many of us grew up with that today, by showing hands? Right? Most of us most of us didn't have that privilege, all right? A lot of us out here ain't had that privilege. And we find ourselves out here going to these churches, selling drugs to our communities, right? Hoeing out our women. You understand? If we find ourselves doing that today, then our parents failed. They failed, or you failed. Because you're not doing what they should have instructed you. You ain't doing that. Come on.
My son, hear thy instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother.
The Bible says, do not forsake the law of your mother. Do not forsake the law of your father. All right, come on.
For they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck.
Right, so these are the things that should make you shine amongst men. Right? But what type of things do we glory in today?
You said what?
What do we glory in today? So God's laws should be your ornament.
You know what?
Right? God's laws, you should be adorned with God's laws. God's laws should make you shine. Right? God's laws should be your light. Right? God's laws should be where your value is. Right? God, what's something simple? Something simple is God's laws is one is that a woman should not wear that which pertains to a man. Right? A woman should dress like a woman.
Right.
A man shouldn't dress like a woman.
Right.
Hell no.
A man should dress like a man.
Right.
That's one of God's laws. Hold that. We're going to come right back. Remember what verse you at.
All right.
Deuteronomy chapter 22. We're going to read it for you in the Bible. This is one of God's laws. Right. This should be an ornament that we put on our necks. Right. You know how we like to wear the watches and the chains, the bracelets, the gold teeth, the
flutes,
all that type of stuff. God's law should be that for you.
Right.
All right. Dressing yourself with these commandments. That should make you shine amongst men. All right. That should set you apart. That should make you feel good. Right. That should build you up, give you the confidence that you need. All right. To overcome this evil in this present world.
Right.
God's law should do that for you. All right. Not the Colt 45, not the blunt. You understand? Not having sex from woman to woman. Right. Those are the things we put on as ornaments today. All right, right, right. Those are the things we put on as ornaments today. Right, the sisters, they want the pocketbooks and the purses and the hair and nails. Right, those things in moderation can be good. Right, not all of them. You can't smoke weed. Right, certain things are not lawful. I'm talking about the things that are lawful. In moderation, you can drink alcohol in moderation. All right, right. You get you a nice bag, put the earrings on, the bracelets, dress yourself up, get the braids. Those things are good in moderation. But what's more important than that?
Jesus Christ
and obeying the commandments that he gave us to keep on this earth. Those things are more important. They much
daughters.
More important.
My
all right? Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse
5.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
What are we reading?
And my two daughters.
Right? Read it again. Read it again.
Shit.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
The Bible says that the woman shouldn't dress like a man. What type of things do women wear today that they shouldn't wear that men wear?
Pants.
There it is. This sister been in the spirit all day since we pulled up.
Right?
Sister been in the spirit all day.
Right?
Now let me ask this. Let me ask you this, brother. What's your name?
My name is Waleed Brother King.
All right. Let me ask you this. What type of things do men today in this society wear that pertain to women?
Dresses.
They wear dresses today. You see that? That's unlawful. Hold on.
Right, well, you are never catching.
Thus saith the Lord, that's unlawful. Now, different brothers got different things they struggle with. Right? So, I might not see this sister ever smoking weed, right? But I might see her in pants and see you got to repent, right? I might not ever see you, brother, with a dress on, but I might see you wake up and you drinking. Brother, you drinking too much. You got to repent. You got to be sober. You understand? It's different laws that pertain to all of us today. We all got issues. I got issues too. We all got issues that we need God's laws to fix us with. Our healing is going to come from God's law. That's what we're going to get our healing from. Right? That's just one law. That's how we dress ourselves. Right? That this should be that ornament. Right? This should be that gold chain, that necklace, those fronts, all those things we like to wear. God says, you keep these commandments. All right? Get your shine on with that. All right? Let your light shine that way. All right? That's how you going to be a light to everyone around you.
Right?
Instead of going after everybody around you. Right? When you do that, then you'll gain some respect. Right? When you do that, then the Arab, you understand, will respect you. You understand? Then the Arab will respect you. Until then, they gonna keep taking your money. Come give me that. All right? I'm a build in y'all communities because y'all so evil and wicked to come together and do it yourselves. All right? So y'all gonna keep coming to my shop, keep coming to my community, giving me all your money, the money that you need for your little babies. Y'all gonna keep bringing it in here so that I can build up my kingdom, so I can build up my wealth and send it over to my people because I care about my people. That's the mindset that every other nation has. But that's not the mindset that we have today. We don't have that mindset. That's the mindset that we got to put on. How are we going to put that on, sister? We got to clothe ourselves with this stuff. All right? We got to clothe ourselves with this. Back to Proverbs.
You said about the children.
Where you were? Come on.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 8.
Come on, man.
My son, hear the instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother.
Come on.
For they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck.
This should be those chains about your neck. Every law we read today in this Bible, you need to consider that a chain of glory for you to put on. Come on.
Verse 10, my son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not.
What did the Bible say?
My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not.
The Bible says if you enticed by sinners, because that's how most of us fall into the evil we enter that. Hey, bro, come on, let's hit this lick. Hey, come on, let's ride out, let's go to the club. Right? Ain't that what we do today? Hey, she ain't home, we can go in through the back door. Right? It's unlocked. She ain't locked the door today. We can go run up in there, right? Ain't that what we do? Somebody come to us with that evil, usually. Guess what? You got a decision to make, black man. You got a decision to make. Are you going to follow after that evil, or are you going to choose the good? Which one you going to do?
Bring it out.
Which one you going to do? Come on.
If they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood.
Let us lay wait for blood, right? Let's wait and trap this man. Let's set a snare for him. Let's set him up. Right? Ain't that what we do today? Set brothers up. Set sisters up. Running gang, that's the same thing. Come on.
Let us look privily for the innocent without cause.
Right. We go after the innocent. Right? The weak, the feeble. That's what we attack. Right? The easy lick. Right? That's what we go after. Right? Anything that we can do and get away with. That's what we want to do. We don't want to get caught. Who want to get locked up? Who want to go to jail? Raise your hand out here. If you can't wait to go to jail, raise your hand. Right? So we're going to try to do the things that we can get away with. Am I right or am I wrong? Come on.
Let us look privily for the innocent without cause. Let us swallow them up alive as the grave and whole as those that go down into the pit.
Right. We're going to swallow them up so there's no escape for them. Right, take advantage of them. You can ruin somebody's whole life, man.
That's right.
With your evil, setting somebody up. You can ruin somebody's whole life, man. And there's judgment for that. It's judgment for that. Either on this earth today or after you die. You will not escape it. Come on.
Well, I tell you one thing.
We shall find all precious substance. We shall fill our houses with spoil.
Right, because everybody trying to come up. Right, we trying to get the latest of everything. We want the latest car. We want the biggest rims. We want the best sound system. Right?
Listen to me.
We want the best shoes, the best clothes. Right?
That.
The best house.
You better listen to me.
Right? We want to go to the best club with the best woman. Right?
Club.
All of that. What the woman doing in the club? Twerking?
Yeah.
We want the best twerker. That's all evil.
But
right? You laughing, but I'm serious. Right? But guess what? That costs money. Where you gonna get that money from? Where you gonna get it from? Doing something evil usually, right? Right? Doing something evil. The Bible says, yo, get an honest job. All right? Make a living. All right? Don't do evil to your own people to come up. The Bible says don't do that. Right? Come on.
Everybody out here.
Verse 13. We shall find all precious substance.
Wait.
We shall fill our houses with spoil. Cast in thy lot among us. Let us all have one purse.
Right, it's enough for everybody. Right?
I know.
You get a small group, we set up, we set it up, right? And we all gonna come up. Right? We all gonna, it's enough for us all. Let's divide the spoils. All right? And we all gonna be straight. Just don't tell. All right? Just don't tell. Right? Just don't say nothing. Right? Ain't that what we say?
Right?
It's evil if you tell. It's evil if you let that word get out. Right, we gotta make sure that don't nobody find out about our evil. That's why when we doing evil, what we doing? We looking behind our back, right? We always got a head on the swivel. Ain't that what we doing? We doing evil? You don't feel comfortable doing that because the Spirit of God is in you. The Spirit of God tells you that that's wicked and you need to repent. And if you don't, he gonna put you to death. That's what's gonna happen. That's why you got that feeling when you doing that evil. Because the Spirit of God lives in you. All right, you can't just do evil, rape, robbery, murder. You can't just do those things. It's not a part of your nature. That's another nature that you learned from your oppressors. That's where you learned that, right? To rape, rob, and murder, you understand? For that to be where you put your faith in, where you put your hope, all right? You've traded your God for another God. This ain't your God no more. The black Messiah is not your God. You know who your God is? The so-called white man. Why? Because that's his religion. Rape, rob, murder. That's his religion. These are the things that he's known for throughout the whole earth. No matter where you go, what you gonna find? Rape, rob, and murder. That's what he's gonna do. Anything you got, where your spoils at? Let me get them. All right, where your woman at? Let me get them. Right? Where your land at? Let me get them. Where your food at? Let me get that too. Right? That's what this man does. But guess what we do today? Perpetuate that in the ghetto.
Bring it up.
In the ghetto. We perpetuate that here in the ghettos. That's not our nature. That's the nature of our oppressors. We've learned it. We got to put that off. That's what repentance is today. Come on.
Verse 14. My son, walk not thou in the way with them.
The Bible says don't walk with them. Don't walk in that way.
Read. Refrain thy foot from their path.
Refrain yourself from their path. All right? Go another way. Don't follow that bad example. Read.
For their feet run to evil and make haste to shed blood.
Do what?
And make haste to shed blood.
We don't even think twice about it today. You know how we make haste to shed blood today? I will sell my brother crack cocaine. I will do that today. I will sell him either one. Right? I'll sell him weed. That's evil too. I will sell him all of these things. Right? That's going to destroy him and his family today. Right? Where did the drugs come from? Who brought drugs into our communities? Who brought drugs into our communities? The so-called white man brought drugs into our communities. That's who brought them. Right? So now we've taken drugs from them, and who we selling them to? We selling them to each other now. But where did they come from? We didn't know nothing about that stuff. Right? But today, we know all about it. We know how to flip it. We know how to cut it. We know how to move it. Everything. We know all the ins and outs of that stuff now. But guess what? That was never a part of your nature. All right? That was never a part of what God had for you. Right? That was an evil brought to you so that another people could benefit from your destruction. That's why those things were given to us. So now today, in these ghettos, we struggling.
Bring it up.
We struggling. Right? We struggling today. And we getting locked up. We in the prison system. But I thought the white man brought drugs to our community. Right? Shouldn't they be in prison? Shouldn't they be locked up? They started it, right? They started it. Ain't that what you said as a child? Well, he started it. I just hit him back. Right? But we locked up, though. I'm talking 75-80% of the jail is who? Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans.
That's right.
God's chosen people. The people you see on that sign right there. All right? Why is that? Because we hate God, and God got a problem with us. All right? And he's a God that loves you. He's not a God that's just gonna let you continue to do evil. All right? And you just wax and wax and wax bold in your evil. Nah, he gonna bring that ass whipping to you. He gonna bring that butt whipping to you. He gonna make sure that you feel it. He gonna make sure that you know what you're doing is wrong. All right? He gonna continue to do that until you repent.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.